Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here. In this video, I'll show you how to use Shopify's new built-in integration for GA4, Google Analytics 4. This is one of the most requested features for Shopify and Google Analytics, so it's great to see it's been added. It makes tracking your store and checkout easy using the latest version of Google Analytics. Before Shopify released the built-in integration for GA4, we needed to add additional code to our store. This means the first thing you should do if you're going to use the built-in integration is to remove any additional code you've previously added to track e-commerce events. Let's head to Shopify to take a look. I've already logged into my demo store, so let's start by selecting Settings on the bottom left corner. Now let's select Checkout. We need to scroll down, and we're looking for the Order Status Page option. We can see in the Additional Scripts section there is some code. And looking at this, we can see it's code to add the Google Tag Manager data layer to the final checkout page on our Shopify store. This data layer is used to dynamically populate details about each transaction so we can send the data to Google Analytics and other platforms using Google Tag Manager. I want to highlight that you might find additional scripts added to your store here. So it's a good idea to copy all of the code and save it in a text file as a backup. Since we're going to transition our implementation to use Shopify's inbuilt GA4 integration, let's remove the data layer. And we can see that the Google Tag Manager container code is also added here, so let's remove this too. Apart from Google Tag Manager, you might also find the Google Tag, gtag.js here too. If you do find the Google Tag here, instead of Google Tag Manager, then you should check if the Google Tag is sending data to Google Analytics, Google Ads, or both. You should consider migrating this to use the Google Channel app. This is the same app Shopify uses for their built-in GA4 integration, so the setup steps are the same, as we'll cover in a moment. Now, if you have any other scripts in the Additional Scripts section, I suggest leaving them. And if you've checked the Additional Scripts section and don't see any scripts here, then you don't need to do anything. Click Save. Okay, now that we've removed the Google Tag Manager data layer and container code, it's time to check if Google Tag Manager or Google Analytics has been added to our store's theme. To do this, let's close the settings. And let's select Online Store under Sales Channels. For the current theme, let's select the three horizontal dots and choose Edit Code. Now let's select the theme.liquid file. This file is used to create all of the product and other pages on our Shopify store, so this is a common place you'll find Google Tag Manager and the Google Tag. For my demo store, we can see that the Google Tag Manager container code is added at the top of the head tag. So let's remove this. I also suggest checking for the Google Tag, gtag.js, as this can also be used to add GA4 to Shopify. Once you're happy that there is no Google Tag or Google Tag Manager container code in the theme.liquid file, click Save. If you've modified your theme to track other e-commerce actions like add to carts, then you'll also need to remove these. For my demo site, I'm not tracking the add to cart or any other actions, so I can skip this step. But if you are, then the most common place you'll find this implemented is in the product template.liquid file, which can be found in the Sections folder. And if you're not sure if any other e-commerce tracking has been implemented, then I recommend talking to whoever set it up on your Shopify store. Okay, so once you've checked that GA4 isn't already added to your Shopify store, it's time to add it using Shopify's built-in integration. To do this, we're going to install the Google Channel app, so let's head back to Shopify to do this. If you already have the Google Channel app installed, then you can skip ahead. If you don't have it installed, then select Sales Channels on the left. and then search for Google. Let's select the Google Channel app. And let's click Add App to install it. Now we need to click Add Sales Channel at the top. We need to log in with the Google account we use to access Google Analytics. And then we need to authorize the Channel app to access Google Analytics. Apart from sending data to GA4, the Google Channel app also lets you send details about your products to Google Merchant Center. If you want to use Google Merchant Center, then you'll need to ensure your store meets Google's requirements. And you'll need to follow the steps to connect to your account. Today, we're just going to use the app to send data to GA4, so we're not going to complete the other steps. So let's click Get Started at the top to set up GA4. Now we need to select our GA4 property using the drop-down. This should be the property for your Shopify store. If you're getting started with GA4 for the first time, then you can use the Create New link to create a new GA4 property. Once you've selected your property, click Connect. We can now see our store will send data to GA4. I also want to mention that when I first tried connecting to my GA4 property, I encountered an error message. But when I clicked Connect for the second time, it worked. So if you see an error, just try connecting your property again. Okay, now that we've set up GA4 on our Shopify store using the built-in integration, let's check that everything is working using Google Tag Assistant. To do this, you'll just need to open a new tab or window and navigate to tagassistant.google.com. Now let's click Add Domain. And we need to enter the URL for our Shopify store. Now let's click Connect. Our Shopify store opens in a new tab. And we can see we're connected to Google Tag Assistant. So let's navigate to a product. Add the product to our cart. View the cart. And now let's click Checkout. We can enter our contact details. And click Continue to Shipping. We select our shipping method and click Continue to Payment. Now we enter our payment details. And let's click Pay Now. The confirmation page loads. And we've now completed the transaction. Now let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We can see all of the data layer events on the left. These are now being created by the Google Channel app we installed on our store. And let's select the GA4 measurement ID at the top. This shows us all of the events sent to Google Analytics. We can see our purchase event, along with page views and other events, including add payment info, add to cart, view item, and more. We're now sending e-commerce events to GA4 using Shopify's built-in integration available with the Google Channel app. And if you run into any problems with the Google Channel app, for example, if you don't see add to carts, purchases, or other e-commerce events being sent to GA4, then I recommend contacting support. To see how to get support, let's head back to Shopify. And let's select Sales Channels. Then select App and Sales Channel Settings. You can then click Get Support for the Google Channel app, and you can ask for help with any issues you're experiencing with the app. Once you've configured the built-in integration, you'll begin to see data in GA4, including the monetization reports. And you can also create your own custom exploration reports using the e-commerce metrics and dimensions available in Google Analytics. Are you using the built-in Shopify integration for GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please take a moment to subscribe to receive all of my latest tutorials. I'll see you in the next video.